Okay, so I'm Amy Hagg for Nympherno on behalf of Total Rock, and I'm here with Matt Brunson of Crowbar.
How you doing?
Yeah. It's really hot in here, by the way. We're both sweating loads, but we do have a cock rock, so that's exciting. We're both very pleased about that. So how did your set go earlier?
It went awesome.
It was awesome.
Super loud, super great response from the crowd.
I saw some kids like crowd surfing as well, some like little children.
Yeah. I think we're pretty much, as far as I know, the first actual metal band to play all day. So, it was good, some great rock bands, but nothing really gets anybody pumped up like metal. So.
It was awesome. And obviously you're on tour for the second time. You didn't get much time at home, did you, between tours?
No, we're basically home for maybe a week or two and then back on the road.
So I saw you in London in March at the Garage. That was a great show. That was your European leg, wasn't it?
Well, no, actually that was just strictly a UK tour.
Oh, right.
We came back, we went to Europe maybe 2 weeks later, and then we finished that run. We came home 2 weeks, and now we're here.
Festivals.
We come home, we're basically home for about 3 weeks, and then we do a show in Philly that this is Hardcore Fest, and then start the third leg of the European tour in Frankfurt.
So. Oh, so busy.
Yeah.
How's Jeff fitting in?
Great.
He looked really comfortable on stage, and it sounds awesome.
Yeah. Really well.
Was it good to, because he wrote Symmetry in Black with you?
Well, actually, Jeff, with Symmetry, he played bass on a couple of tracks, but me and Kirk pretty much, we wrote the record. The reason being is not to exclude anybody, obviously, but we had a tour in December already booked, ready to go. So Jeff had to learn our set.
Yeah.
So we really couldn't it was just not good timing. And we had to work him in on a set with the harsh deadline we had for the album.
Yeah,
basically,
sure.
we finished that tour on the 13th of December, I think. And then the 16th of December, we went into the studio to start recording, and we had to have the album finished by the 14th of February.
Yeah, you did it really quickly. I remember seeing all your updates about it.
Yeah.
But it's awesome. I love it. It's
thank you.
Heavier and groovier than Sever the Wicked Hand, isn't it?
Yeah, Sever was it was one of those things where it had been a while since there was a Crowbar album, and we had a new lineup. So there was a lot of different kind of flavors, so to speak. But, and it wasn't as if we were trying to do anything different from what we did. It just, for whatever reason, it just ended up coming out differently than more of the normal Crowbar records. Because, mainly, especially Kirk and I personally, we're going through a lot of really rough stuff. So, of course, when you're having a bad time, your music is going to come out.
Yeah.
Usually the message is going to be a lot more positive.
Yeah.
That was a really positive record because we wanted to do the opposite of how we were feeling.
Yeah.
Whereas, with Symmetry, everything's really good. Everybody's even. So now it was you draw on those negative times that happened years before, and that's why it sounds so dark.
It rocks. I really love it. It's really groovy.
Yeah.
I know. I probably shouldn't say that about Crowbar, but it's how I feel.
Yeah.
So, peace and love, whatever.
Yeah.
So Kirk's with you guys full time now.
Yeah.
He's given up down.
Yeah.
Is he a lot happier, do you think, in that?
I don't know about, I can't speak for anything that went on in the down camp, obviously, but, he's just, his focus is so, razor sharp.
Yeah.
I think it was one of those things where it gets to a point, you always go home, as I like to say.
Yeah.
So, it just got to a point where, he wanted to focus on Crowbar, and, for whatever reason, he felt that he needed to do that exclusively as opposed to splitting it up. So.
But on the flip side, Pat left to go to down.
Yeah.
So, it's an interesting dynamic. But Jeff seems to have gelled really well.
Yeah, we all
sound great as a band.
Yeah, we all get along really well. So.
Awesome. So Kirk's the only founding member left.
Yeah.
24 years?
25.
25. Yeah. Wow. That's amazing. I just can't imagine being in a band that long. That's just insane.
Me either.
But 10 albums, is it?
Yeah, this is number 10. Yeah.
Awesome. So are you doing many more festivals now?
Well, this is the last one for this run, but as far as I know, we're doing Resurrection Fest in Spain. We're doing Bloodstock. I think we're doing Brutal Assault.
Mm-hmm.
And then I think there's some other smaller festivals.
That's a really good lineup, Brutal Assault, actually. I was looking at that, I was thinking,
I get that. But how's life on the road? Are you itching for a real bed?
You know, it's one of those things. We were talking about that earlier. When you get out, we've been out for almost 3 weeks now. So when you get out that long, it starts to not matter, you know?
Yeah,
so
yeah.
And the other thing is with me, like, you know, like Kirk, you know, they have kids and all that stuff to get home to. Tommy's got a fiance and all that. But for me, it's just like, you know, I can stay out.
Rolling stone.
Yeah, pretty much.
Awesome. Well, I'm about to die, so I'm going to wrap things up now.
Yeah,
but thank you so much for taking the time to talk to us, and have a great Hellfest.
Thank you.
Signing off.